Next one is dynamic memory allocation. When we need dynamic memory allocation, what are the different types of functions we are going to use in dynamic memory allocation? We face situation in programming where data is dynamic number of data items keep changing. During execution of the program, because the situation in programming where data is dynamic in nature, that is, the number of data items keep changing during execution of programs. Example, list of customers, they keep changing during executions. That means every instance, the customer number keep changing. Now we require a dynamic memory allocation. Dynamic memory allocation is used in such situations. As and when memory space is required using the library function such as malloc, malloc and relloc memory can be allocated. That is, whenever a memory space is required, the situation where the input is going to change dynamically. In that case, we are going to use some valid functions such as malloc, calloc, and relloc. Well, the memory space is not required. The reserved memory can be deallocated using a library function that is, whenever memory is not required, the allocated memory can be allocated by using a library function free. function and its task. Malloc. Malloc is a function which allocates requested size of bytes and return pointer to the first byte of allocated. The malloc function allocates a requested size of bytes of memory and returns the counter to the first byte of the allocated space. Calloc is another function which allocates space for an array of elements initializes them to 0 and 10 returns pointer to the memory. The second function, calloc, it allocates space of an array of elements. Then it initializes them to 0 and returns a pointer to the memory. Realloc is another function which modifies size of the previously allocated space. That is, if you want to change the size of the memory which is allocated by the malloc or calloc, then we need to use a realloc which modifies the previously allocated memory space. And one more function, that is free. Freeze previously allocated space. The free function returns back to the system whatever the memory is allocated, previously allocated. Now we discuss how this memory allocation process happens in the C language, C programming. So where we get the dynamic memory? The memory is divided to number of blocks. C program, that is text and instructions, are at the bottom of the memory. Global variables. This is permanent memory. Permanent storage area This is E. I'm span all open variables. Don't print up stack. The program instructions. I global as well as static. The variables are stored in a region for permanent storage area. That is the program text which contains the instructions as well as the global and static variables. They are going to be stored in a region called the permanent storage area. All our local or stored in stack area or stack region. Now, in between stack and permanent storage, there is a space called key. The memory space. Okay. Between stack and permanent storage area. This is called heap. And available for application. During execution of the program. In between the stack and permanent storage, there is a space called free space, it's called heap, which is going to be used for dynamic memory allocation during program execution. I size of the key. Keeps changing. Program is and depth of variables that are local to functions. I that is the size of the heap keep changing. distributed due to the new arrival of the variables, the creation and the death of the variables, or the local functions and the blocks. Therefore, it is possible to overflow memory domain dynamic allocation situation. Memory allocation function malloc around returns the null pointer. In the process, the malloc along the real log functions returns the null pointer. Hence, after using the functions and performance of the execution program, we need to release the memory by calling the function free in the program. Malloc. Allocating a block of memory. The malloc function allocates a block of memory may be allocated using function malloc function reserves the block of memory of specified size and returns a pointer of type Y. The block of memory is going to be allocated using the function malloc. The malloc function reserves a block of memory of specified size and has a pointer of type Y. Syntax pointer equal to data type malloc size. We create a pointer variable and of data type. Data type is any data basic data type of user defined size number of bytes in Y. Example, India in malloc 10 into size of 8. Here, we are allocating 10 blocks of integer through the malloc function of type integer. Diagrammatically, 10 blocks of memory of int n by of space address of first byte. That is 10 bytes of memory is allocated by the alloc function, and the address of the first byte will be held by the appointment in the card. Now, we may also use the law to allocate space for even complex data to such as structures. Even you can allocate the memory for the structure using the malloc function, which is the complex one. Example, structure variable hello. Hello, here's a block of contiguous bytes. Along. Allocating multiple blocks of memory gets along. Then size. The log is used for encrypting memory space at the runtime. Such as arrays and structures. The malloc allocates a single bomb of storage space, whereas cannot allocate multiple blocks por especie. I am each of same size. Then, first of all, size to zero. The Mallard allocates single norm of mature species, whereas the Mallard allocates multiple blocks to a species, and all the blocks are of the same size. Then it sets all the blocks to zero. Syntax. Size. This statement allocates continuous space for n number of blocks. That is total number of bytes allocated is equal to 1 into size I all bytes or initialize zero. And the address of first byte return to the point. It allocates a continuous space for n number of blocks and each of the size. The total number of bytes allocated is n into size, and all bytes are initialized with the zero, and the address of the first byte is assigned to the pointer. The required memory is not available. The null pointer is taken. The required memory space is not available in the heap, then another pointer is required. Third function is realloc. It's called the one. Size of a block. The total memory allocated, you feel it is insufficient, then we can go for alternate size by taking the function realloc. That is, whatever the memory allocated by using either malloc or malloc can be altered by using the function realloc. The memory using malloc or malloc. Need change or modify because of insufficient then we require additional memory for some applications. Then we go for the function called realloc, that is, we have to reallocate the modified bytes. It is also possible previously allocated space larger or to reduce size of using the malloc functions, we already allocated memory, which if it is larger, then we want to reduce the size. Use a reallocation function, resizing. In such a situation, side of allocated memory can change value. Example, PTR, malloc, the log function is going to be modified by using the real log function by its syntax. We are going to size. The sufficient memory is available, then the first address remains same. If the request is not available at the present location, then we go to shift to the new location and assign the new address to the PTR variable.